mighty in battle. Then he took one step and began to say, oh no, he cannot come out. Then he grew again. Jesus applied the blood again. Now he now spoke to them again, this time with a more powerful authority. And he said, I say, raise up your heads, all ye gates, and be raised up, ye everlasting doors. And they ask him again, who is this King of glory? Now he told them exactly who he is. He said, the King of glory is the Lord of hosts. Every host bowed to me. Every host obeyed my voice. So all of them were paralyzed. And Jesus stepped out. And the grave became empty. He came out with two things. The keys of hell and the grave. I ask you tonight, this morning, my brother, my sister, it is apostolic keys. The keys to lock down hell, the keys to open hell, is in the hand of one that believes that Jesus rose from the dead. If you believe that Jesus Christ, the Son of God, rose from the dead, then you get the keys. Understand it. Every problem, sickness, disease, finances, business, whatsoever, they come from the gates of hell.
Amen.
And I want you ministers of the gospel to take note. We are meant to solve problems.
Amen.
But you cannot solve problems when you don't know where the problems come from.
Amen.
Once again, therefore, my beautiful friends, gates are not just this kind of gates or doors.
Amen.
When we speak about gates in the spirit realm, we are not talking about doors.
Amen.
They are spiritual symbols.
Amen.
Gates are spiritual symbols of authority and power.
Amen.
When Jesus was talking about the gates of hell, he was talking about the authority and the power of hell.
Amen.
He said, it shall not prevail. The word prevail means it shall not conquer you that follow me.
Amen.
It shall not conquer you that believe in what I am doing.
Amen.
But these days, Christians are just receiving barrages, arrows, all kinds of nonsense from the same hell that their Lord conquered.
Amen.
Somebody from today say arrows.
Arrows.
Say arrows of hell.
Arrows of hell.
Come out.
Come out.
And enter no more.
And enter no more.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Yes. Every financial, every health, every success, every prosperity that have been hindered.
Amen.
Every blessing that have been hindered.
Yes.
Every dream that have been hindered from coming to pass.
Amen.
Every vision that God Almighty planted in the instant that have been hindered. They are hindered by the defeated authority and the powers of hell.
Amen.
That's why I tell you that Christianity is not a joke. The way people tell you, don't worry, just be, don't worry, just play. No, it's not just playing.
Amen.
Your eyes must be red as fire.
Amen.
Amen.
So that when you approach, the gates of hell begin to shut.
Amen.
Say, oh, she's coming again. She's coming again. You cannot hold her money, let her go. She has come again. Everybody approach hell, hell is not a thing, but when you approach hell, they are shaking like
my God.
My God.
My God.
I know many of you, you don't like this kind of message.
Preach it anyway. Hallelujah.
And I have said it, there's so much stupidity in Christianity. All kinds of worthless message. That's what they will rise and be shouting and crying. But when you deal with authority of heaven, no, they are just there looking. Whether you like it or not, that is the truth.
Amen.
You don't come to church and go the same way.
Amen. Glory.
You cannot be at the beautiful gate and be begging.
Amen.
Is the gate of hell?
Amen.
Whatever your problem is today is the gate of hell.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
It takes apostolic anointing.
Amen.
To be able to do what God said. And I'm not talking about apostles that have been wounded.
Amen.
You are wounded apostles.
Amen.
We have arrested the apostles.
Amen.
They are sent for the arrest.
Amen.
We have people like Ananias and Sapphira.
Come on now.
They were arrested by greed.
Amen.
And they died by the gate of hell.
Amen.
So many like that.
Amen.
That was why Paul refused to be arrested.
Amen.
He said, I fought with the beast of Ephesus.
Amen.
Amen.
give him some praise. Everywhere Paul went, he was in position. Do you know that Peter shifted out of position? Paul had to correct Peter. He said, Peter, it was your fault. You cast it. Peter was a senior apostle to Paul. But Peter at that time lost his position because of Jewish culture. Some of you, because of American culture, you have lost the touch of the gospel. Because of the world who want to come into the church, you cannot be controlled by the world. You
Yeah.
And raise all your sweats. And come come before me as a woman and change your vocal cord. Hi, baby. I'm not moved by that flesh because I have a glory which must explode. Do I have a church here? And this is the truth unto you that I've been ordained to God. God called me from my mother's womb.
Amen.
They wanted to kill me. My mother had me in her womb, and the enemy wanted to kill me right in the womb. The battle was awesome. God was fighting.
Amen.
The prophet must be born.
Amen.
How I came out, my mother didn't know.
Amen.
I was in the military. They planned to kill me. God was fighting.
Amen.
In this Atlanta, there is no rumor, there is no lie they have not said.
Jesus.
In order to frustrate
come on
the
now.
Work of God.
Come on.
But the gates of hell will never prevail against your apostolic mission. So I say this to every one of you, to get yourself in position. You know the lies, you know the secrets. I still lead your worship team. Every day, you are in a battle.
Amen.
Because the greatest people the enemy attack are worshipers.
Amen. 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 This is true.
If you know how to worship, that's why I keep telling you why. You think it's a joke. Many of you today, it is either car or nonsense, you will not come to church at the time that is supposed to. Are you not ashamed of yourself that God will be waiting for you instead of you waiting for God?
Amen.
You should be ashamed. Shame should come upon you.
Amen.
You have no respect.
Amen.
For your position.
Amen.
Let me tell you. You must control your problem.
Amen.
I don't preach because I want people to make me an empire.
Amen.
All over the world, I'm known.
Amen.
If you don't know me, if you don't want to care about me, it is you who will suffer the consequences because I carry the unction that you need.
Amen.
Yes, I do. Carry it. I'm not that kind of preacher that beg people.
Amen.
You must come to
Amen.
Me.
Amen.
To alleviate you of your problem.
Amen.
If you don't, if one city doesn't receive me, I will go to another.
Amen.
And by the power of the Holy Ghost,
Amen.
Another city will thrive.
Amen.
I will make it. Somebody shout glory. It's because when the anointing is out, that is where people beg people.
Amen.
Ministers are not meant to beg.
Amen.
People should come to the anointing.
Amen.
If you have respect for the anointing, you will long for it.
Amen.
In Genesis chapter 22, verse 17, this is one of the blessings that God released upon your great-great-grandfather called Abraham.
Amen.
He said unto him, that in blessing I will bless you.
Amen.
In multiplying, I will multiply thy seed as the stars of heaven. That is to say, Abraham has the ability to multiply business, money, everything that he does.
Amen.
And you can hear that the Bible says Abraham was very rich.
Amen.
How did he do it? God now told Abraham, he said, and your seed shall possess the gates of your enemies.
Amen.
That is the secret.
Amen.
If you are not possessing the gates of your enemy, you cannot multiply.
Amen.
Multiplication comes because you are in control of the gates of your enemy.
Amen.
Once you can control the gates of your enemy, get ready for expansion.
Amen.
Get ready for financial prosperity.
Amen.
Get ready for healing. Get ready for every blessing that is due for you.
Amen.
Once you can control the gates of your enemy.
Amen.
In the book of Judges, there's one man that I love so much. A lot of ministers have preached against him in many ways.
Amen.
But I won't. Yes, he had his own share of mistakes, but this is what came in the life of this man.
Mm-hmm.
This man was a Nazarene. No reason was omitted to to come to enter his hand.
That's right. Yes.
And I saw what happened in the life of this man in Judges chapter 16. If you look at verse 2 and 3, he was one of the greatest men that fulfilled
Amen.
The blessing of Abraham. He took the gates of his enemies.
Amen.
He carried the gates.
Amen.
And that was why the enemy was angry with him. They now went and sent a woman into his life called Delilah. Now, Delilah is a destroyer.
Amen.
That's why I keep telling you, nobody wants to bring you down. People, God sent us to lift you up.
Amen.
But you cannot be lifted until you forsake the wrong.
Amen.
Do we all make mistakes? Yes. But don't be locked down in your mistakes.
Amen.
And as you get out of it and move forward.
Amen.
Because of the grace of the Lord Jesus
Amen.
Christ.
Amen.
If you fell yesterday, you can rise to him.
Amen.
Those of you that have been ordained, if you have your ears, listen to me. You are going to make mistakes. Stop mocking those who made mistakes.
Amen.
Because the more you mock, the more you lie, the more you tell lies, or the more you speak about those that make mistakes, you are digging your own grave.
Amen.
The race is not for the swift. The race is not for the perfect. The race is not for those who are powerful.
Amen.
For those who are covered by grace.
Amen.
That's what the race is about. So if you are covered by grace, you are not to mock those that fall.
Amen.
But you must do what you can do to make sure that they get back onto the race. I am ordained by God to rescue, to look for those who have been injured on the mountain. Every one of you that have been wounded, I come to call you, to rescue you, and send you back to the war front. Let people say anything they like about you. They are not your God.
Amen.
When they see you rising, they shall repent from evil they are talking against you. Somebody give them some praise. This woman, give me that Judges now. Look at that. I'll close now. Look at that Judges. This man called Samson. He just finished sleeping with the harlot. He went and slept with a harlot. Verse 2. And it was told that the Gazites, don't play with the Gazites. The Gazites.
Amen.
We still have Gaza now. And it was told that the Gazites saying, Samson is coming here. Gazites are gates. Then I told the gate, Samson has come. And they compassed him in and laid wait for him all night in the gates of the city. That's where they prepare evil.
Yeah.
The gates
right.
of the city.
That's right.
And we're quiet all the night, saying, in the morning, when it is day, we shall kill him.
Oh my God.
Amen.
But look at the anointing and the grace upon Samson's life.
Amen.
Those who waited for him to kill him.
Yes.
He finished them.
Amen.
Verse 3. And Samson lay till midnight. He didn't do it in the morning. He didn't do it in the afternoon. He waited until midnight hour.
Amen.
Why did Paul wait till midnight hour? Why did Peter wait till midnight hour? Because the midnight hour is the third hour. It is the hour when the evil powers are lying down and sleeping. That is when you should take your aim at them. Somebody shout power. It was midnight hour that Jesus Christ finished his work. And what did he do? I took the doors of the gates of the city and the two posts and went away with them, bar and all, and put them upon his shoulder and carried them up to the top of a hill that is before Hebron. What he was saying to them is that, I have taken your city.
Amen.
I have taken your city.
Amen.
You know why you have the keys? The keys are meant for you to lock down hell.
Amen.
And say to hell, you cannot perform.
Yes. Amen.
Hallelujah. So if you have been ordained as elder, deacon, deaconesses, you are not for cheers.
Amen.
You are for souls.
Amen.
You are for harvest of souls.
Amen.
If you are a musician, stop playing, stop behaving as if you are a gangster.
Amen.
Because you are a musician doesn't make you a gangster. A musician in the house of God is supposed to be the most humble and the most holy worshiper of God. Because the strings you are playing, they are supernaturally ordained. You are either playing for the devil or you play for God.
Amen.
I know somebody who used guitars to call demons. Yes. I know somebody who used flute to call demons. And when she uses, it's a lady, when she uses that flute, the realm of the supernatural will be charged.
Amen.
She's opening gates.
Amen.
You have to be careful.
Amen.
So that your destiny does not get destroyed.
Yeah.
The drums can be used to invoke spirits.
Amen.
Right. And many things you need to know. Amen, church.
Amen.
So when you stand on that key, let it be Holy Ghost divine.
Amen.
When you stand on that drum, let it be Holy Ghost divine. Amen. Yes, we may want to dance, but let's dance
come on now
in holiness.
Amen.
My beautiful friends, as we round up, I want you to know
Amen.
That Jesus said in John 16:33, He said, "In me, you will have peace." But right there in the world is the gate of hell.
Amen. Yes, it is.
The world is the gate of hell.
Amen.
He said, in the world, you will have tribulation, trouble.
Amen. That's what it means.
He said, but let not your heart be troubled.
Amen.
I have overcome the world.
The world.
Amen.
That's
right. Amen.
So, my beloved friends, I come to tell you, the gates of hell must submit to you.
Amen.
If Jesus conquered them, and you have the name of Jesus, they must submit to you.
Amen.
They must submit to you.
Amen.
It's time to take the kingdom.
Amen.
According to Matthew 16:19, our text. Blessed are thou. The blessing is for you to take the kingdom.
Amen.
Solomon said, the blessing of the Lord maketh you rich and add no sorrow with it.
Amen.
The blessing is meant for you to take the kingdom.
Amen.
I will give you the keys of the kingdom.
Amen.
You can knock down kingdoms of this world.
Amen.
We have dangerous prayer warriors that will speak to presidents of nations. You are not moving.
Amen.
You don't have to go to White House.
Amen.
All these people that say, we are protesting, we are going to White House. You don't have to go to White House.
Amen.
You can be in your room and lock a king down.
Amen.
It's the authority that is given to you by God Almighty.
Amen.
We must take this world.
Amen.
And we must take it for Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
And those of you that have been ordained, whether you're ordained as prophets, prophetess, deacons, apostles, or whatsoever the Lord ordained you in any office, you must understand that the secret of a true worker of God is submission.
Amen. Amen.
Submit to the authority of God.
Amen.
Don't bite the finger that feeds you.
Yes. Amen.
Be very careful.
Amen.
Holiness is not about what you touch.
Amen.
Or what you don't touch. Holiness is about what comes out of your mouth.
Amen. Amen. Yes, it is.
About people.
Amen.
What do you say about this man?
That's fine.
Amen.
What do you say about that man? What do you say about this girl? What do you say about this person? What do you say about this person? This is what brings destruction or prosperity. Slap your foot and say, watch what you say about me.
What do you say about me?
You cannot win people that you are talking evil against. You can't win if you are a soul winner. How are you now talking evil about the same soul you want to win? You can't win a soul when you are evil in heart about that soul. Because the soul will see you in the spirit. Your position is throne of grace.
Amen.
Your position is throne of grace.
Amen.
When you operate from the throne of grace.
Amen. Come on, Apostle.
As you have been ordained today, you are ordained in the knowledge and the power of triumphant church.
Amen.
Operate from the throne of grace.
Amen.
This church in Atlanta will flourish like a pumpkin.
Amen.
And then grow like the seed in heaven.
Amen.
My friends that come from Florida, you see the gift that God has given you. When you now begin to do it directly from the throne, Africa will call you.
Amen.
Europe will call you.
Amen.
Because your star shall be sighted from afar.
Amen.
That's a prophetic word.
Amen.
Those of you that are here, as you begin to do things in truth and in spirit, you don't have to struggle for popularity.
Amen.
When you do it on the throne of grace, because of the gift you got, every nation will be calling you from everywhere to come under the triumphant command. The same thing goes with you, my friends. Whatever you do, any business you lay your hand to do from the throne of grace,
Amen.
You can't be doing business in the dust.
Come on now, come on.
The dust is the power of a curse.
Amen.
When all of you want to dress, I'm not against the way you dress. But when you dress on the throne of grace,
come on, my Lord.
You don't need mirror.
Amen.
A mature woman that dresses from the throne of grace, you will dress and people will look at you and say, that's truly a child of God.
Yeah.
Because I don't know who you want to impress.
My Lord.
That's right.
Jesus.
It's the truth.
There are certain dressing you will dress. You cannot use that to win soul.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. It's the truth. Wisdom.
If you are not changing,
Amen.
You will be left behind.
Amen.
Every day, we are taking steps of change.
Amen.
Amen.
I wasn't like this 5 years ago.
That's right.
Amen. I wasn't like this 3 years ago.
That's true.
But as the Lord moves me, I'm changing.
Amen.
No man is perfect.
That's right.
It's precepts upon precepts, lines upon lines, and you will get
there. Amen.
I come today to dispute your keys.
Amen.
And there is nothing the devil can do about it.